So, dear student, welcome to our next video lecture. In the previous video, we have seen the brevis lattices in two dimensions, and we know that there are in total five brevis lattices in two dimension, but the crystal systems are only four. There possess two types of lattices in case of a rectangular crystal system, isn't it? The say rectangular primitive and rectangular non-primitive or rectangular centered, that we have seen in the previous video. Now today we are going to discuss brevis lattices in three dimensions. So as discussed earlier, there are seven crystal systems and 14 brevis lattices in three dimensions, and these lattices are inconsistent with what we call as a symmetry operations, or we can say point group operations. As usual, we know that a lattice is represented by a conventional unit cell for which the sides are made up of the fundamental lattice vectors, fundamental translation vectors, which we can call as a vector A, vector B, vector C. Also, there are three more parameters associated with these unit cells, and that are the angles between the fundamental translation vectors, namely angle alpha, beta, and gamma. So here you can see, in this case, we have denoted fundamental translation vectors by A, vector B, vector C. Also, the angle between A and B is gamma, angle between vector B and C is alpha, and that of the angle between A and C is considered as beta. So this we can change actually, but throughout the discussion, we will be considering these as the angle and vectors A, B, C as the fundamental translation vectors, isn't it? Now, depending upon the values of the vectors A, B, C and the angles alpha, beta, gamma, there can be different types of crystal systems. Broadly speaking, they are called, they are seven in numbers, and corresponding to these seven crystal systems, there can be at the most 13 lattices, which we call as a brevis lattices. So let us discuss one by one all the crystal systems and related 14 types of brevis lattices. So as you can see here, the very first crystal system, which is the simplest one, and that is the cubic crystal system, isn't it? For cube, the fundamental translation vectors A is equal to B is equal to C, and the angles between them, that is alpha, beta, and gamma, these are all equal, and they are equal to 90 degree. So how we can represent this cubic crystal system or cubic brevis lattice? That is simple. We have to draw the cube here. This is simple square. All sides of the squares are equal, and we can draw a cube from that. By drawing the lines like this. And here, the cube will get completed. Now, so this will be the unit cell of the cubic crystal system. As usual, now we can assign the vector fundamental translation vectors as, now this vector is vector A, this vector is vector B, and this vector is vector C. But since for cubic system, the lengths of the vectors, or we can say the magnitudes of the vectors, are equal, so simply we will replace all the vectors by same letter. Let us call vector A, vector A, vector A. Since for cubic system, all the vectors are equal in magnitude. Similarly, these angles, we can see the angle alpha, beta, gamma, all these angles are equal, and they are equal to 90 degrees. So this is the cubic crystal system. Now, as far as lattice is concerned, we have to show the lattice points at each corners. Now, here you can see here how many corners are there. We can say this is one first corner, we can say, then this will be the second corner, then this will be the third corner, then this will be the fourth corner, then again you come to the next fifth corner, sixth, seventh, and this is the eighth corner. So as far as cubic crystal system is concerned, the lattice point exists at each of the corner. Now, such a crystal system which consists of lattice point at each corners only, that is called as simple cubic crystal system. That is called as simple cubic crystal system. Simple cubic. Now, and this cubic system is denoted by letter P, capital P. Examples of simple cubic systems are Cu, Ag, Fe. All these metals falls in the category of simple cubic system or belong to simple cubic system. Now, for the same cubic crystal system, there can be another type of system, another type of lattice, which we call as a body-centered cubic lattice or body-centered lattice, that is denoted by letter I, and examples are sodium Na or NaCl, sodium chloride. So what is the difference between cubic system, simple cubic, and body-centered cubic? As usual, as we know, in case of simple cubic, there are 8 lattice points at 8 corners each. So along with the, in addition to the 8 lattice points, there is one more lattice point at the body center of the entire cube. So such a system will be called as a body-centered cubic system. The periodic arrangement of the lattice is such that the lattice points happens to be at the 8 corners plus at the center of the system. So this will be called as a simple cubic, and then another one is body-centered cubic. The third, for the same lattice, we can consider for the same crystal system, we can have one more type of the lattice, and that will be called as a face-centered cubic. Now, what is the difference between body-centered, simple cubic, and face-centered? Now, we know that for the time being, I will remove this lattice point, which I have given at the center of the lattice, because now we are going to discuss face-centered cubic. So, to discuss face-centered cubic, I have removed the body-centered lattice point, and now again it is simple cubic lattice. So, as far as face-centered cubic is concerned, face-centered cubic means now this is a cube, and there is a lattice point at the center of the each face of the cube, in addition to the 8 lattice points at the 8 corners. So now how many faces does a cube has? Cube has 6 faces. Cube has 6 faces. We can see here. This front face, back face, 2. Then this is sideways faces. So again there are 2 faces, 4 faces. And then upper face and lower face. So in total there are 6 faces. So on each of the face, there is one lattice point at the middle of the face. So such a lattice will be called as a face-centered lattice. So I have shown the lattice point in the middle of the upper face. Similarly, I can show lattice point at the bottom, in the middle of the lower face or bottom face, we can see. Two lattice points. Okay. Now we can go for the side faces. So this is the lattice point on the face at the left side. This is the lattice point on the face on the right hand side in the middle. So sideways face jhale ani upper and bottom jhala. Now front and back. So as far as the back face is concerned, this we can say it is the lattice point at the middle of the back face, the backside face. And this we can say, this is the lattice point in the front side of the face. So in total, there are 6 faces. Each face has a lattice point at its center. So we can say this, lattice as a face-centered lattice, isn't it? Now, this is about, so we can actually extend this discussion to the number of lattice points per unit cell or per unit cell. For example, if we consider simple cubic lattice, then we know that for such a simple cubic lattice, there are lattice points only at the, there are lattice points only at the corners of the unit cell. Then in this case, obviously, when we think of the entire lattice formed by such a unit cells, then what will happen? Each of the lattice point will be shared by 8 adjacent cells, 8 adjacent unit cells in the lattice. So we can say for a particular given lattice, for the given unit cell, only 1/8 of the lattice, only 1/8 share of the lattice point will be there for particular unit cell. Because this particular lattice point will be shared by 8 nearby adjacent shells. So contribution of a lattice point to this particular shell will be only 1/8. Similarly, here also only 1/8. Here also only 1/8. Here also only 1/8. So total share for the simple cubic lattice will be just 1/8 plus 1/8 plus 1/8, or we can say 8 into 1/8. So this will be simply 1. So we can say this also I have discussed while in the previous videos. So contribution to the the number of lattice points existing in simple cubic shell will be simply 1. Lattice points per unit cell will be, per unit cell will be 1. Similarly, if we consider body-centered cubic, then in that case, body-centered cubic lattice, there will be one more lattice point at the middle of the, at the body center of the cube. So total lattice points will be 2 in case of body-centered lattice point. On the other hand, if we go for face-centered cubic lattice, then total number of lattice points will be calculated as below. There are 6 faces. So all these faces will be shared by adjacent cubic, adjacent unit cells, isn't it? Adjacent unit cells. So what will happen? contribution of a particular lattice point to a particular phase only will be only 1/2. So 1/2 lattice point will be shared by each phase as far as the given sail is concerned, isn't it? So in that case, body centered lattice will be given total number of lattice points in case of phase centered lattice will be given by using this formula. There is one formula that gives the lattice points per unit shell, per unit cell, and the formula is total number of lattice points per unit cell n is equal to ni plus nf by 2 plus nc by 8. What is ni? Ni is the lattice points well within the unit cell, inside the cell. Nf, lattice points on the face of the cell. And plus nc, nc is lattice point at the corners of the cell. So nf is the faces. So n, for example, simple cubic face centered असेल, face centered साठी body center मध्ये काही नसतो, plus 6 faces असतात divided by 2 plus 8 corner असतात divided by 8. So there will be simply 1 plus 3 plus 1. So there will be 4 lattice points in case of face centered unit cell, face centered cubic lattice, we can say, isn't it? 6 faces, each cell has 6 faces. So 6 by 2, it is 3. 8 corners by 8, so it is 1. So total there are 4 lattice points in case of face centered cubic. On the other hand, body centered cubic madhe kay asel, face var kay nasel, but inside the body, inside the cube asel, so it will be simply 2. So that I have explained to you previously. So this is all about that cubic crystal system and the associated body centered cubic, simple cubic, and face centered cubic lattice, isn't it? So similarly, we can go ahead and we can think of another type of crystal system, which is tetragonal crystal system, which is called as tetragonal crystal system. So what is the tetragonal crystal system? You see here, tetragonal, for tetragonal, A is equal to B, but it is not equal to C. That means out of the 3 vectors, 2 vectors are same, but third vector is having different value, different magnitude. And the angles are 90 degree each. All the angles are 90 degree. So how we can show the cell here? We can show the cell of tetragonal unit cell as, I will change the color so that it will be easy to understand. So again, we can show here tetragonal system. A is equal to which vectors we have taken? A and B and C. So A, this is A, this is B. So both are same. So I have shown the by using same letter, indicating that the magnitudes of these two vectors are same, and only C vector is different. Only C vector is different. So it is C, A and C. I will again redraw the diagram. So it is vector C, slightly having different length than that of the vectors A and B. It can be smaller than A and B, or it can be greater than A and B. It will not matter. Now, but angles are 90 degrees. So all angles are 90 degrees. I will not show here to avoid the confusion. Now, let us complete the unit cell. we can complete the unit cell corresponding to tetragonal crystal system. In this fashion. So this is what we call as a tetragonal unit cell, tetragonal crystal system. So again, there are two categories, two types, simple tetragonal and body centered tetragonal. So obviously, for a simple tetragonal cell, there will be one lattice point at each corner as usual. So this will be called as a simple tetragonal system. It is indicated by, represented by letter P as usual. The examples are beta SN and NiSO4. On the other hand, as far as body centered is concerned, in case of body centered, there is one more lattice point in addition to the corner lattice points at the center of the entire tetragonal unit cell. So this will be called as a body centered tetragonal. An example, the material which falls in this category is TiO2. Similarly, now we can go ahead and we can go for next crystal system, which is called as orthorhombic. For orthorhombic crystal system, we know that the fundamental translation vectors are all different. A is not equal to B is not equal to C. The lengths of the vectors are different, but angles are 90 degree. Angles between them are 90 degree. So again, we can draw this figure for orthorhombic system as this is vector, suppose B slightly different, vector A and again, sorry, to draw the figures is somewhat difficult. So this is the vector C. Vector all different. So I have shown each vector by different symbol as usual, A, B, C. Okay. So again, you can complete the unit cell of this lattice by drawing the lines as usual. So this will be the tetragonal, this will be the orthorhombic lattice. Again, there are four types in this orthorhombic crystal system. As usual, first is simple. So for simple lattice, for simple orthorhombic, there are lattice points at each corner of the unit cell. At each corner of the unit cell, just a minute. At each corner of the unit cell. So this will be called as a simple orthorhombic lattice. For body centered lattice, there will be additional lattice point at the body center of the orthorhombic lattice. So this will be called as a body centered orthorhombic. Example is FE3C. For face centered, as usual, there will be one lattice point at each face of the entire orthorhombic unit cell. So that will be called as a face center. In addition to these three types of lattices, namely simple orthorhombic, body centered orthorhombic, and face centered orthorhombic, there is one more type of lattice in this category, and that we call as an end centered orthorhombic lattice. Now, what is meaning by end centered lattice? End center means there are lattice points on two opposite faces of the unit cell any two opposite faces. For example, here we know that there are six faces placed opposite to each other. So there are in total three faces placed opposite to each other, pair of three faces. For example, front face, back face, left face, right face, and upper and down face, upper and lower face. So there are three pairs of faces placed opposite to each other in case of in case of any unit cell, isn't it? So end center means for, in case of end center, there are lattice point at the center of the two faces, two opposite faces. If we select upper face, then there will be a lattice point on the lower face as well. So this will be called as a face center or body face center. This will be called as a end centered or base centered orthorhombi. End centered and base centered are same. Names of the same lattice. So this is what we mean by end centered or base centered orthorhombic lattice. The material belonging to this end centered lattice is cementite. Now we can go for the next lattice system, which is next crystal system, which is called as rhombohedral or trigonal crystal system. For such a system, A is equal to B is equal to C, and alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma, but these are not equal to 90 degrees. Now here, the angles are different than 90. Angles are other than 90. But length are same. So we can also draw the system for this also. You consider angles are same. So we can draw vectors of same length, but the angles are different. So I have drawn here by mistake, angles are 90 degree. So angles are different. So here you can see here, if this is the vector, as usual, it is vector B. So we will denote this by same letter, as usual, vector A. Now angle is different. So again, it is, we can show it is A vector because they are same. And to show the difference in the angle, we will draw the vector C, which is equal to vector A as well, by like this. So here, what is happening? Alpha, beta, gamma are equal, but not equal to 90 degree. 90 degree peksha vegle ahe, paramtu te kaya ahe? Equal ahe. Equal ahe. So in case of three dimension, we cannot show all the angles are as equal, but other than 90 degree. There is limitation, but we can draw in such a manner. And then again, you complete the unit cell as usual. So this will be called as a rhombohedral or trigonal crystal system. To this crystal system, only one type of lattice is belonging, and that is only simple cubic. So as usual, there will be lattice point at corners of this unit cell. So it is called as trigonal, simple trigonal lattice. Examples are arsenic, SB, that is antimony, bismuth, calcite, etc. So this falls in the category of simple rhombohedral crystal system lattice. Now next is hexagonal. Hexagonal lattice. So obviously, as the name indicates, the unit cell of this lattice may be hexagonal or cubic or cubic, or we can say tetragonal, isn't it? So here hexagonal, for hexagonal A is equal to B and it is not equal to C. So that is hexagonal lattice, and alpha is equal to beta, which is equal to 90 degrees, but gamma is different. Now, what are these alpha, beta, gamma? I have shown in the upper separately in the figure. This is vector A, vector B, vector C. For hexagonal, A is equal to B, but not equal to C. And alpha and beta are 90 degrees, but gamma is 120 degrees for hexagonal. So let us draw this figure now. So for hexagonal, we can draw a hexagon first. We can draw the hexagon first, and then we can draw its unit cell. Put my disadvantage actually. Okay. So this is simple hexagon. Then we can complete the hexagonal unit cell. By drawing lines as usual. So you can refer to the any book for accurate figures. So this can be the hexagonal crystal system, and for the lattice, the unit cell is of hexagon type. So here also only one lattice is there, which is simple hexagonal lattice. So as usual, there can be lattice points at each corner. Lattice point at each corner. So here it is. I am showing the lattice points at each corner. At each corners of the hexagon. Now, just a minute. Now, this unit cell may be cubic, or we can say tetragonal. If lengths are different, then it may be tetragonal, or it may, if lengths of all the vectors is same, then it may be cubic, and as you, we can just wait a minute. So this is, I have duplicated that. So if we are having all lengths equal, then like this. So if here lengths are equal, like this. So this can be done. So this can be the hexagonal unit cell, isn't it? So again, it may be having lattice points. As usual. Now we can consider unit cell of this hexagonal crystal system in two ways. First is here, if we join the center here, you can see here. You can think of this shaded portion. So this seems to be a cube. This seems to be a cube. This is a cube. How many cubes are there? You can think of, you can see here. I have shown this actually, this to you also. You can see here. This is another. This is another cube, and in total there may be three cubes. In total there may be three cubes, isn't it? So this is actually cube, and one more we can draw is here like this. So it is difficult to draw actually, but we can draw here, isn't it? So the point was, the in case of hexagonal lattice, the unit cell may be cubical type or it may be of that hexagonal type. We can consider either of the two. You can see here. Yesterday also, in the previous lecture also, I have shown this to you. You see, this happens to be the cubical structure, isn't it? So there are there can be unit cell of cubical type, or if the length is different, then it will be of different type, isn't it? So this is all about hexagonal cubic hexagonal crystal structure. And there is only one type of lattice, which is called as simple cubic. In simple cubic lattice, there are lattice points at the end faces of the unit cell also. And here the angles are the alpha, beta. Alpha is equal to beta, and that's equal to 90 degree, and gamma is equal to 120 degrees, isn't it? So this is all about hexagonal cubic lattice. Now next lattice is monoclinic. Next is monoclinic, for which A is not equal to B is not equal to C. All the vectors are different and alpha is equal to beta. Two angles are equal, but the third angle is not equal to 90 degree. Two angles are equal to 90 degree and third angle is not equal to 90 degree. So in that case, again, you can draw the unit cell in similar fashion. So now we have to draw this unit cell. Alpha is equal to beta. So we cannot draw these pictures actually. Ideal pictures we cannot draw. All unit cell will seem like, but the parameters are different. The parameters are different, isn't it? So here A is not equal to B is not equal to C, but alpha is equal to gamma, equal to 90 degree, and it is not equal to beta. So again, there are two types of lattices. Simple lattice, so as usual, there will be a lattice point at the corners. Example is CaSO4, 2H2O. End center madhe kay hoil, fakt don opposite face la kay asel, lattice point asel. So gypsum, that example of that, end centered cubic lattice. And finally, we will be having triclinic system. It is it is special actually. It is not it is having least symmetry, that is triclinic, for which all the vectors are different, all the angles are different and other than 90. A is not equal to B, B is not equal to C. So there was a battery problem. Battery was discharged.